And now, continuing as we're on, following every little step of every little step, the journey of Chorus Line, this great, wonderful documentary. If you see it, you'll feel like you just saw a Broadway musical, because that's what it's about. We have the documentarians, the directors, Adam DelDeo and Jim Stern. Yes. Welcome to the Stag Hall
Thanks for,
show.
Thanks for having us.
Well, thank you. My God, what a beautiful film.
Thanks.
What a beautiful film. How did you ever get it made? I mean, with how many years did it take? I mean,
it took a couple years, but what happened is that John Braulio, who was the producer of the revival and the executor of Michael Bennett's estate, Michael always had this idea that a Chorus Line was sort of a documentary in itself.
And it was, yes.
And
yes.
He had said to John, if you do this again, if it ever goes to Broadway again, I'd love to have a documentary on the show. And so John had seen our prior film, So Goes the Nation, and he called
him. Wonderful doc, which is about something very different, about the Florida Bush.
Ohio Bush Kerry, and that's right, and Bush Kerry election. And
such a logical step to a Chorus Line.
but I have produced 16 shows on New York, so I produced The Producers and Hairspray and Stomp and many, many
others. You were the producer?
Well, I mean, one of the producers.
Oh, wow.
Of all
congratulations,
those shows.
Yeah. Sir.
16 times I've been on.
You've been through it.
I've been on the board 16 times, that's right. So, and John had said, Braulio had said, you know, I have the original tapes, which no one had ever heard. And,
And
I immediately called Adam and said, I think we have our next film.
Yeah, so we had a conversation about this opportunity and, you know, number one, it was a Chorus Line. It won more Tony Awards than any show on Broadway to date. It won the Pulitzer Prize. It had been performed all over the world in so many different languages. It was, you know, truly iconic. But, you know, what struck us was that, you know, that this opportunity to follow dancers in New York going through an audition process, struggling, examining their lives, trying to get a job on the line, that it actually mirrored what Michael Bennett had created with respect to
A Chorus Line. Yes, absolutely.
You know, he examined, starting with that night, you know, that cold, snowy night in New York in January 1974, he examined that night dancers' lives. He started by saying, hey, this is what my life is about. This is where I came from. Talked about his sexuality and things that were really deep and dear to him. And, you know, that night dancers talked about their lives and that then created a Chorus Line.
And it was taped in like one of those tape recorders that nobody uses anymore.
That's right. It was a reel-to-reel tape. They got together. Bennett brought these 19 singers and dancers together at midnight and, you know, had all these reel-to-reels.
That's so wild. And, it was midnight.
And with Saturday night, it was after their shows, or the ones that were in shows, and with wine and other substances that got them all talking, and he sort of revealed some things about himself to get them started.
I use coffee, lots and lots of coffee.
That's what I use too. In any event, this is recorded, and then it ends up in John Braulio's safety deposit box, and John wasn't even sure what condition the tapes were in when he first started talking about this.
Oh, well, that's what sort of one of the things that made the movie for me was hearing Michael's voice and hearing,
yes.
And then you followed his process because you know, I'm playwright myself, and I was writing musicals, or I used to, was how the hell did he do this? How did he go from just a bunch of people talking into the brilliant songs and lyrics and, you know, structure?
It's an extraordinary process, but, you know, I agree. I mean, I'm a real structuralist also, and I was fascinated. And this is the first time a workshop had ever been used. This is the first time
anybody.
And now every show we do has a workshop.
But you showed everybody, us, the viewers, how that's done quite completely. And there can't be any questions now because you really covered it. And yet you kept it all as fluffy as possible in terms of it being a movie. And so it was serious and also entertaining and also funny.
Well, we were very, you know, conscious of rhythm in the film. We wanted the movie to move.
It was like a musical, actually.
That's what we wanted. Yeah.
So strategically, we mapped the film out. You know, we had watched a lot of musicals. We wanted the dance to be very kinetic. We had 7 or 8 cameras on any given day shooting.
Crisscrossing
New York, shooting different dancers.
Oh, of course, because you had to follow their lives and stuff. They weren't like all in the same room shooting.
That's correct. And then, you know, in the third act,
yeah, right.
For the final callbacks, you know, we had cameras all over that all over that stage. And so, you know, we wanted the information about structure to be in the film. That was very important. That was, you know, critical to making the film work. That historical information, but kind of weaving it into the film in a way that multi-layered the movie in a way that Bennett created the original show, and we were creating our film. There was really this, we're trying to hit this perfect metric.
And Sony Pictures Classics is distributing it. We love them. They do the they get it out there, whether it's the doc or whatever.
We love them.
Every little step is going to be just everywhere very shortly. When is it opening?
Yeah, they have a great team over there. You know, headed by Tom Bernard, Michael Barker, Dylan Lyman.
We love them. We love
incredible
them.
Incredible bunch. It opens this Friday in New York.
Oh wow!
April 17th. At the Lincoln Center
in New York and LA, and then it flows from there. It's going to be in about 40 markets after that.
So if you're in New York, you got to go see it at the Lincoln Center theaters, or the Chelsea, or the Angelica. Those
Or in Los Angeles, it'll be at the ArcLight and Landmark theaters.
In the Landmark, that's right.
Right, and you'll be on YouTube too. And we have to go. Oh my God, my art took up all the time. Anyway, thank you so,
much,
Adam and
Thanks
Jim.
So much.
You're both
thank
brilliant,
you.
Brilliant.
Thank you
so much for
Thanks
being here today on the Stephen Holt Show. And have a fabulous day.